Actually, as a liberal Democrat, I'm quite interested in promoting liberal art, you know. Sometimes, you know, modern art may be, you know, in the state of devastation at times. I think as our artists, you know, sometimes choose some kind of petty themes instead of going out for beautiful images and bringing a real renaissance to modern art. I'll tell you about my visit to Bergamot Station. It's kind of an art gallery in Santa Monica, California. It's known for its number of large rental shops, you know, for artists, you know, like painters mostly, and they bring their paintings. And I even discovered a pigment photo, photo pigment imprint. So you can imprint your own colorful photo picture, you know, onto a canvas. And it's done about for about $100. Anybody would do that, like maybe $100 to $200 worth for the pigment imprint on a canvas, you know, on a ground canvas, you know. It's been done by some internet companies, you know. Or even some Bopo photography.com, you know, introduced his photo pigment imprints of eyeballs, you know, human eye on a canvas. And it costs about maybe $3,000. I thought it's way too much because internet portals, you know, sell the same services of photo pigment imprint for only about $200 worth, or maybe $300. But $3,000, charging $3,000 only for maybe about 6-inch by 40-inch, you know, canvas, is way out of proportion, you know. As I visited Bergamot Station, some artists like Bielski, Anna Bielski, you know, she depicted a kind of iridescent kind of human shapes, you know, like that woman with kind of rainbow color legs, that actually resembles the blood that iridescent spills or oil spills were actually thrown at her, you know. And it costs about $2,000, this kind of painting, with the size of 40-inch by 30-inch painting costs about $2,000, and it looked like it had some duplicates. It's been done too. So, but what kind of paintings were our expensive? Well, actually, I even have seen that one artist whose name was Magia. I want to pay special tribute to his gallery. Actually, the gallery was contained mostly young Caucasian girls, you know. Somehow he spot young Caucasian girls on 40 by 30 inch paintings, which looked like no brush strokes were been done on them at all. And look like photo pigment imprints, you know, was painted. Depicted all about teenage girls, you know, kind of mostly. And it looked like was imprints, you know, didn't contain any brush stroke whatsoever. So it looked like photo pigment imprints, you know, being passed away as a painting, you know, as a fraud. I believe that in the charge of about $300, $3,000, not less than $3,000 for each painting, it's like that. And that guy looked like magenta tube, he was quite a redneck. And I believe that actually what kind of paintings canvases are way too expensive, you know, and only for middle class America, and only wealthy people can afford it, same thing like that. But there were very few visitors there, if any, you know. And, well, actually, also Maguire introduced his paintings of that little girl under the steam train locomotive, near the steam train locomotive. But it looked like there was no brush strokes on those paintings. And actually, that's why I was a little bit frightened by those prices. Some artists even charge $2,000. One art studio charged about $12,000 for only one painting of a human figure size, natural human figure size of a naked woman. And that painting was even unfinished, you know, the bottom wasn't even done properly. And I thought that only wealthy people can afford that kind of price sticker. And again, well, actually,